up in the test lab here. So what I have, some strain gauges, and I have a rosette, and I'm going to look at them individually. So here is my rosette. So in our Neo, test lab Neo, if you go over here and you click on the button, you will be able to use this Goodman and damage calculation. Wow. Then you're going to select an XML file, and I'll open that XML. So here we have a material database with some demo SN curves in it. And you'll see when we run the process, it'll ask you to select one. So I get my materials database. Let me reject this and hit run. And now it's going to call up a window. So here's my window. So this is my material curves, my material database. If I want to add an offset. So some people, what they do is they balance their gauges all the time. So there is no mean in their gauges. And they record an assembly strain. So some people add that assembly strain back in and then run this. If they didn't add it back in, you could type it in here. So for one of these, I'm going to say something like -5. And then hit OK. And then it's going to crunch through it. And we should get a Word document that pops up with a fancy diagram. Now, I had two runs in here. I should have explained that better. I apologize. I had two runs in here. So I said calculate all at once. So all the runs are going to come on. There's six channels and they all come on one plot. So here is my Goodman diagram. The yet red is the go, no go area. And then we calculate the safety factor and a safety margin. So this is the one I added that big negative mean stress to. These would fail. Here's my margins. And a lot of times people won't say one, they'll say like 1.5. It's got to be at least 1.5. Anything below one is a failure.